Okay, okay. Now, we're back with this slim Xbox Pass ploy. Customers come in with it. Said there was a burning smell and a bit of a pop, and now there's no power. So, we'll just check this out. Rightio, I'm just going to unsolder this shield plate. You can buy these power supplies fairly cheaply, but sometimes it's nice to track things through. Okay, I'm just going to zoom out this camera so you can get a bit of a better view there. Okay. Main filter capacitor. Be careful, that could be charged up. I did one once before and that was charged up. I'm just going to measure the voltage across it. That's not nothing, so it's not charged up. Okay, so Ryan Ohms, you have got a fuse here. Which is blown. So our fuse is blown, so therefore we've got a short somewhere. Normally it's the chopper transistors. Sometimes it can be the bridge rectifier. So a bridge rectifier is these four points here, AC in, DC out. And there we go, we've got a short. Short on our bridge rectifier. See that? Now, they've got a short. So our bridge rectifier here, bridge rectifier, that one there. So we're going to whip that out. Whip that out and then we'll measure it when it's out, okay? Okay, it's soldered on both sides of boards, this bridge rectifier, so it's going to take some getting out. So what I've done, I use alloy low melt solder. I'll just put some flux on there. So we'll just add this, just basically re-solder the point you've already got. Now I've just noticed there's glue. Okay, now I just reheat this alloy solder. It's a low melt and it's used for desoldering, and we just all we have to do is get the heat through and it'll go right through the other side of the board. And she's out. Okay, back again. I'm just going to clean up. Just trying to make sure I've got the camera where you can see there. I'm just cleaning up where the fuse goes. Yeah, hold on, bad. Just a bit there. Okay. There's a bit of solder in the hole there, so I just normally just resolder the hole again, and it normally just goes up through there like so. I just had the customer call about this just as I was working on it, which happens a fair bit. So all these rectifiers do is rectifies the sine wave, okay? 240 in, DC out. You don't get 240 out because it's 0.707 of the, you know, the sine wave, it averages out. So it's 0.707 of that. Thank you. Okay. Well, the fuse is a 4-amp fuse. So you could even solder a glass fuse in there if you wanted to solder two wires on it, and then put heat shrink over it. Okay. Okay, now there may be more faults with this. Sometimes something else goes short, takes your rectifier out, takes your fuse out. So it may have more faults, we don't know. Just gonna check this diode here. And that's a dead short. Okay. So we've still got more issues. Okay, that diode shorted. Here's another one I've got here. That one's alright. We're going to take that diode off now. That could be the main culprit. Is that diode shorted? Taking the bridge rectifier, taking the fuse. It's a bit of a chain reaction. This diode only goes in one way because it's got obviously a Dubina diode, it's got an anode and a cathode, so you just don't want to. It's held in by a little bit of glue there, see? Just to prove it is that diode, we need to measure it. It's a short, see that? Point, shouldn't read a short. But that diode's gone as well. So, we'll pull the diode off me spare here. Make sure this one comes off and you put the new one on, transfer it and put it on exactly the same. Diode's got a line on it, so make sure it goes back and might come out. Okay. Diode in. What else is wrong with this thing? output from the 240 in, output from the rectifier. So that's open, so that's well not open, but MEG, so that's that circuitry's okay there. Now that's okay. What else could be wrong with this thing? Okay, looks okay, we're ready for a test. Just be careful of 240. This is, you can kill yourself. I'm a qualified electronics technician. So this is really for educational purposes. Disclaimer. Have we got voltage coming through, baby? Have we got it? Have we got it? Have we got it? No, we haven't. Okay, we've got issues. Have we got DC here? Yes, we have. Have we got voltage on our capacitor? Have we got voltage up here? Yes, we have. And we still got nothing out of here. Okay? So now your primary side of your power supply is working. Obviously you had a short on the secondary, taken out. It's a snowball effect, taking all. You can't short the secondary and have the primary survive, so it's obviously shorted all that out. Okay. Okay, so we've got our primary side, all that's blown up, that's all fixed, but we now have voltage on this capacitor. DC volt, but disappears from there. But what I've happened to notice is I've lifted this capacitor up, and I've got a blowout. You can see the track has been burnt. It's had a blowout. This diode here, and that runs up. This FET transistor here. So we're looking at replacing that FET, that diode, and maybe this oscillator chip, TEA. But look, you wouldn't go too much further than what I've gone. It's just not viable. At least the primary, I've fixed a primary, showed you how to fix a primary side of your power supply. But it's just gone far too far to be economical. Maybe when I've got more time, I could go further and we'll fix this at a later date. But yeah, it's just not viable, I'm afraid, to do too much more with this one. Bit of a shame. So yeah, probably on another video I'll go further and I'll start replacing those components through there. But that's as far as we're going to go at this stage. So basically your bridge rectifier, your fuse rectifier, that diode, at least all that shows you how to repair the front end of your power supply, okay? I've got this power supply that I looked at a few months ago and we tracked it through. The primary side was working. It's not blown out here like the other one is, and I tracked it down to this chip. Remember, we had a low resistance on the output. We tracked it all the way through to this chip. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to remove that chip off the power supply that I just looked at and try to get this one going. So I'm going to go remove that chip and then we're going to put our rectifier back in, our fuse back in, and we're going to throw that chip, replace this chip from the one that I just fixed the front end power supply on, that's blown out, but the chip's probably okay. We'll see how we go, and we'll pull this chip off and we'll see how we go. So back shortly. Okay, so I'm going to pull this chip off. This one we reckon was causing our problem with our resistance. I've already half removed this from previously than what I pulled off last time. Cut that off. Just going to clean up that here. This is the one I just pulled off. This is the one I just pulled off that blown up one. Which hopefully is all right. Making sure I've got the right way around. Right, yeah. I can feel it coming, yeah, tonight. Oh Lord. Okay, she's in. She is in. She is in. And can I show you the multi? I can't zoom back out here. If you can see that meter, multimeter there. Now we measure across the output, and we're not getting a 27. We're not getting a 57 ohms now. It's getting a high reading. Okay. Hopefully, this is fixed. Two forty in. see the multimeter, about 3 high now, 400 volts, 600 ohms going up, the reading capacitance. Will this work? Will this work? Come on, come on, baby, come on, baby. Come on. DC volts. DC, there we go, she's fixed. We have 12 volts. Okay, so this power supply, the only thing that was wrong with it, it was the one I looked at a few months ago, was this chip. Okay, which I put the specifications with that chip. I've taken a photo of it, and there we go. So there we go, we managed to fix the Xbox One S Slim power supply. This is the one I looked at a few months ago, and we couldn't fix it, we didn't have the chip. So I pulled the chip off that other one that was blown, which I just showed you the tutorial on how to fix the front end. And she's a worker, so she goes back in and she got 12 volts on it, so she's all good. So thanks for watching, and please subscribe and have a nice day.